relationship that can save your life. Jesus gives us abundant forgiveness for our sins, for our failures. No one else can do that. Romans 6:23 says, "For the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord." Amen. It is the only relationship that will matter in the end. He is coming ashore. It could be today, it could be tomorrow, it could be 100 years from now. But what we do know, we don't know the time, we don't know the date. All we know is that his coming is imminent. Amen. The important thing here is that we have to be in constant state of readiness, spiritually and physically. Romans 14:11-12 says, "For it is written, as I live, saith the Lord, every knee shall bow, and every tongue shall confess to God. Every one of us shall give account of himself to God." Amen. When you have a personal relationship with Jesus Christ, the Holy Spirit will abide in you and help you to walk and talk. And you will thrive and not just survive. Amen. When you have the Holy Spirit within you, you definitely will walk the walk and talk the talk. Because the Holy Spirit is there to guide you. Yes. He says his word is a lamp unto our feet, a light unto our path. Amen. So his word is sure. Yes. It's sure. We have to stand on his word. Amen. Turn your Bibles to Philippians 4. And we are going to read from verse 4 through verse 8. Here I will show you the things that we need to do to thrive and not just survive. And when you get there, say amen. Philippians 4. Amen. Philippians 4, verse 4 through 8. "Rejoice in the Lord always, and again I say rejoice. Let your moderation be made known to all men. The Lord is at hand. Be careful for nothing, but in everything by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known unto God. And the peace of God, which passeth all understanding, shall keep your hearts and minds through Jesus Christ. Finally, brethren, whatsoever things are true, whatsoever things are honest, whatsoever things are just, whatsoever things are pure, whatsoever things are lovely, whatsoever things are of good report, if there is any virtue and if there be any praise, think on these things." Beginning in verse 4, it is as though Apostle Paul looks into the future, considers all possibilities of sorrow, and in spite of them all, repeats the command to rejoice at all times and in all circumstances. Is nothing less than a call of faith. Can't do anything without faith. Faith and works. So it's nothing less than a call of faith. For if the believer believes that his life and all its circumstances are in the hands of a sovereign, wise, and loving God, who is always working to accomplish good for him, then he can indeed rejoice always. So if you think that you have a sovereign God, a God who loves you, a God who's working for you, then you should always be rejoicing in everything, in all things. Rejoice.
Brothers and sisters, when there's nothing better that we can do, there is nothing better that we can do but ask the Lord to draw us close to him. So we're going to stay close to him, amen?
Amen. Amen.
Amen. Praise God.
Draw me close to you.
Never let me go.
Never let me go. I lay it all down again to hear you say that I'm your friend. You are my desire,
and no one else will do.
No one else will do. 'Cause nothing else can take your place. To feel the warmth of your embrace. Help me find a way. Bring me back to you. Help me know you.